Today I thought I'd do something a little bit different and talk about eye health. And the reason I wanted to do this was because we're all using screens, either computer screens or laptop screens or our phones, all day every day. And while these are helping us be really, really productive, a lot of the time they're seriously damaging our eyes with stress and strain and sort of interrupting our sleep and all sorts of stuff like that. There's three really simple tips in this video, along with some free software, some apps that you can download that should help you with this. And the reason I wanted to make the video was because I've always had really sensitive eyes. And in having to deal with this, I've learned a few things along the way that I'd really want to share with you guys too. They've really helped improve my quality of life and just sort of how comfortable I am when I'm working, and also my quality of sleep. And I thought that just by sharing them with you, they might help improve your quality of life too. I've also had lots of messages and comments from people who say that they're completely burnt out with their eyes and ears just after a few hours of making music. So I'll probably address the hearing in a different video. Just before I get into the tips, I wanted to talk about why screens are bad at all. So it's really down to two or three things. One is how close they are to our face, making us quite short-sighted over time if we don't take breaks. The second thing is the intensity of light they emit. Simply the sheer brightness is not good for us all the time. And the third thing is the blue light that they emit. And this blue light interrupts your sleep hormone called melatonin. And if you're using screens late into the night, you can often find that it's really difficult to sleep or to get restful sleep when you finally do. So with that kind of bit of background, let's jump straight into the tips. So the first tip isn't very glamorous, but it's all about diet, lifestyle, and health. I've left some more information in the description as to sort of some dietary factors that could cause eye strain and stress, but just overall, you want to make sure that you're exercising, you're drinking plenty of water, and that your diet's really balanced and really healthy. And alongside your diet, you want to be making sure that you're taking regular breaks from your screen. Often the best thing you can do is just every half an hour or every hour, simply step away from your studio or your screen and go just look at other stuff, go outside, try to focus on distant objects so that you're not just focusing on stuff that's really, really close to your face, and just give your eyes a little bit of a rest. Tip number two is trying to deal with the intensity of light and also the blue light. And this is where we can download those free apps that I was talking about earlier. Minimizing the blue light that gets from your screen to your eyes can be done in two different ways. Either you can wear like gaming glasses or sort of orange tinted glasses that prevent the blue light hitting your eyes, or you can deal with it at the screen and use a blue light filter that changes the color temperature of your screen. There's a few options here. If you use Windows 10 and you're on the latest update, you can go down to the bottom right hand corner and activate this sort of nightlight mode, and this will change the intensity of light and the color temperature of your screen and make it a lot softer on your eyes. But if you're not on Windows 10 or you're on any other sort of system, you can download an app called Flux, and I use this on all of my devices. It's free. And basically it changes the intensity of light coming from your screen and also the color temperature depending on what time of day it is to try and match your surroundings. Using this one app alone made a huge difference to how much stress and strain my eyes were going under every day, and also the quality of sleep I was managing to get. The blue light being blocked from my screen meant that my sleep hormones could just like get themselves back into order, and I was finding myself feeling a lot more rested. And if you're more rested, your eyes are getting better recovery and more rest obviously when you're sleeping, which means that you're not going around in this sort of toxic cycle of damaging your eyes, not managing to recover, and then just damaging them more every day. You're actually getting the rest that you need to recover. I also install these apps on my phone, and I'll show you a little bit of a demonstration here. I think the one I use is called Halo, but there's loads of them that are great. Just find one that works for you on the App Store. I'll leave a link in the description to the one I use. And you can just toggle it on and off and then change the intensity and the brightness. And if you're using your phone at night, especially if you use this, you'll find that your eyes will just thank you so much for using this. Your eye strain will just go down right away when you're using it. And the only thing you really need to be careful with on the screen and on the phone is that you get the right balance between the brightness and the color temperature so that your eyes are being protected from the blue light, but you're not like squinting to try and see the screen, because sometimes I would set it a little bit too dark and then I'd find that while my eyes were not being stressed by the light, I was actually squinting so much just to try and see the screen that I was probably causing some damage to my eyes anyway. If you haven't tried these apps, or if you're only using it just on your phone or just on your computer, I would really urge everyone who's watching just to try and download them for free. You've really got nothing to lose, and I really do think that they're gonna help you. The third and final tip in this video is about reducing glare onto your screen, or from your screen, I should say. Anyone who's worked beside a sunny window will know what I'm talking about. So in our last home studio, we had a great big window right beside our computer, and this was amazing for the views and the fresh air and all that. but it was glaring straight onto the screen, and I would spend all day sort of squinting at my screen, and I didn't really realize the damage this was causing to my eyes long term. So if you do have any kind of glare coming off, you might want to look at maybe curtains or repositioning lights in the room or repositioning your screen. There's also some other options you can do with sort of like film screen coatings and stuff like that. I haven't looked into those, but it's just to be aware of. You might not be aware of it, but the next time you're sitting in front of your screen, just try to see if there are any lights sort of reflecting back off from your room to your screen and then into your eyes, because it's really not good for you to have to sort of squint past that all day. So those are the quick tips for this video, but I've also left a lot more information in the description for anyone who's interested, just sort of ways to relax your eyes and de-stress your eyes after a hard day of work. It's something that I've really struggled with over the last couple of years, but also just my whole life, to be honest, and I just hope that sharing some of this information might be able to help some of you guys too. And if anyone has any other information, just please leave a comment down below. I'd love to hear it, and I'm sure that anyone else who's out there suffering or struggling with eye strain would like to hear it as well. This isn't really a topic that I see too many people talking about. A lot of people do talk about ear strain and fatigue, which is great because you really need to talk about that and address that too. But I just thought I'd talk about this just from my own personal experiences. Also, do bear in mind that I'm not a doctor or anything like that. This is just all from my own personal experience, so be careful with whatever you do end up trying. So thank you very much for watching. I hope you gained something from this video, and I hope to see you in the next video too. Bye for now.